Okay, let's try to fix this wheelbarrow wheel. I will not use this one because it's also too loose. And this is from here. That's the only reason why I'm using this. Okay, so I have two problems. One, and I will use this one, which was on that wheel. And I also, this one is broke from inside, and I will fix it because I believe it's less damaged than this one. These three are new. This one came inside that, and I have two broken when inflated. So let's try to fix this one from the inside of the wheel. So let's try to take it out. Usually want to take it out from here because it will first time just take something and pull this little knob inside to take out the air and press it a little because it's harder to take it out with air. You can use some clamps if you want. You can also unscrew this, but I don't have with what, so I will use this method, which is harder. Maybe you don't have also. Okay, now we have something. You take something like a screwdriver or like this. Preferable screwdriver because it's okay. What the heck are you not coming out? Okay, now we want to press it here and take it out. You can put two of these if it is easier with two of them. Maybe I should get another one. It works better with two screwdrivers. You want this one to be in the middle. I don't want to break my table, so that's why I'm not pressing a little harder. Should put something on. Let's put a cardboard. Usually it's easier, maybe because of this it's harder. I don't know. I don't know why it is too hard. It has only 4 years or 5. And it was new. Okay, now we want to take out the parts from the inside because you want to don't damage this valve. Just take care to not pinch the one which is inside. Okay, has some dirt inside, a few holes probably, so. I will go and put some air in it and see what happens. So here it is, it doesn't look very bad. It's too small though, the water bucket. If you see air coming out, that means it has a damage. But I don't see any damage, so what the heck? Okay, I will put it in another water just to see, just to confirm that it doesn't have any air problem. Well, I don't know. I don't see any air coming out. So it's from 2016. Okay, I will wash it. This is great. I have one good one. See, I was preparing to show you how you can fix this. Maybe I will show you on that one. We'll try to fix it. Maybe it works. We don't know. but I don't have an envelope like this. A tire. I don't have a tire, so I'm surprised that it doesn't lose air. Very surprised. I wash it because I don't want smaller rocks. Okay, let's keep it here a little dry. So now I will wash this one inside. Okay, I see that. So I also clean this one, and I will put some. I will wait a little and put some electrical tape on here, because it started to. To have some damage, it might penetrate my rubber. Does it? Replacement inner tube, so it might damage my inner tube, this one. So I will put an electrical tape here. I will let it dry a little, and after that I will come back with the video and continue. And I will make another video how to fix the inner tube if it's damaged. I will fix this one. Yes, I know it's too big a damage. This one it's okay, but this is too much to fix, and it's too close for this. So if I can do it, you can do it too. If you're living in a homestead far away and you don't have something to change it, or you have three like me and you have to make it the four, I will show you how to do it. But for now, let's pause it and wait to dry this and put something. So let's find some electrical tape. Be right back. I'm back. So I tested again this one. It doesn't have any holes. So I will take out the air. You don't want to take all there, but most of them. You want to put it easy back. Well, this is enough. It's easier to put it back, so let's do it. Okay. So I told you I will put some electric tape here because I don't want to be pinched. I was thinking to sand it, but no anymore, not anymore. I might do more damage than good. So let's put electric tape. You can do this trick even on the bikes. for the rust and also not penetrate the inner tube. Let's put twice. Okay. Well, if it's, it feels way better. Okay. Let's clean this up. Okay, let's start doing. Okay, I don't like this too much. Too dirty. Okay. Any small piece of rock can damage your. I should clean this probably a little. The heck, not a very good blend. Okay, this is okay, it's okay. Okay, let's use it. Okay, one is done. So now I have to put it the second one. I will put it from the other side, it's easier. See where the hole is. Where the heck is the... Oh, it's on the other side. Try to not to... But I will show you how to inflate. But I will not show you because I inflate it on the upper. Okay. Here's the hole. You fix. First you have to put the valve in the inside. You can put the rubber piece to not go back inside. It's like no. Okay. I don't get it why it doesn't fit easier, because it's his tire. Okay, it's inside. So now I start from here, from the valve. And press it. Oh, a little more. Okay. So now all you have to do is to put it this straight. You inflate a little and after that you make it like this, because you want to be perfectly arranged. So that's all. Be right back. See? This is it. This is a little inflate. You want to arrange it better. See? That's perfect. Now I can inflate it to the maximum, and that's all. To the recommended pressure. Well, this is it. See? 2.5. I put only 2.5. So it says maximum inflate 330, I put 25. 1.5. Yes, I. It's perfect. The inner tube is the one who matters the most, actually. Okay, I will clean it a little and put some lubricant from BD40. I'll use a few of this and that's how you change it. I will make another video. I will make another video how to fix that one. It's a big wound, but if I can do that, you can do a smaller one. Yay! It's good for another 3 to 4 years. We'll see. And I'm very glad that the envelope was great. You can see how to fix that in my other videos. I don't know if I put it now, but I will make a video about it sometime. Okay, this is it. I wish you a nice day. Bye-bye.